All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios. And joining us now from our Toronto studio is Alan Carter, the president and CEO of Cabral Gold. And Alan, great to talk to you. Enjoying Toronto?
Yes, Steve. It's nice weather here today.
Yeah, and so you're obviously meeting shareholders, meeting your board. Is that what you're doing in Toronto?
Yes, I'm updating shareholders on our recent draw results, and several of our board members are based here in Toronto, so I'm here on a regular basis.
So let's talk a little bit about the latest results. Last time you and I talked, you talked about that you were drilling nine targets, and these are their new targets, something you hadn't previously drilled before. So you've gotten results back from a couple of them, and I would imagine you're pretty excited with the results.
Yeah, I mean, when we spoke last, about 3 or 4 weeks ago now, we just got the results back on the first target, and they'd never been previously drill tested. It's a target called Machichie. And the best hole that we got from six holes as part of on that target was 3.4 meters at 36.9 grams gold. So that's a pretty spectacular result in a brand new area. I did mention that we would be moving to the second target. And so yesterday we released the results on the second target, and we have another zone. The results aren't quite as good, but they're still very, very good. It's a 16 meter wide zone. Running 1.7 grams a ton, but within that there are two high-grade sections running. One is running over 10 grams a ton, and the other one is over 20 grams a ton. So it looks like we're a second discovery here, Steve. So that would be two for two. And as you mentioned, we're in the process of drilling nine of these targets. So I don't expect that all nine will run these kind of results, but it's a very encouraging start.
So when you talk about the next steps now, as far as the next holes that are going to be coming, are you looking for following a certain direction now, or because of what you found here, will alter that at all? What's sort of the plan?
Good question. Well, we're targeting a number of east-west trending structures that we can identify on the basis of the airborne magnetic data. And these east-west trending structures are very significant because we already know that we've got one deposit associated with a very strong east-west trending structure at the project. We've identified approximately 12 parallel zones, and so we're in the process of testing as many of those as we can. We're heading from south to north. We've now tested five of these parallel structures in the south, and as I said, the first two, we've got the results back. We've just finished up drilling target number six, and we're moving to target number seven, which is from the north. And the idea here, Steve, is to ultimately demonstrate that and I think we're well in the process of that, of demonstrating that there's an awful lot of unrecognized high-grade mineralization at Cuiu Cuiu.
You were recently there, as a matter of fact. You just got back on Friday from Brazil. So tell us how your trip was. Obviously being on site is always good when you get a chance to look at things firsthand.
Yeah, it's always nice to take a look at the core. So we spent quite a lot of time with the core on site. We're generating quite a lot of drill core and the sampling process. We're in the process of building a new base there, a new camp in the village where we currently work from. It was a good chance to sort of like catch up with everybody and see how things are going. I'm very proud of what the guys have done so far to get two new zones, to discover two new zones from the first two targets. And this is only a reconnaissance drill program. I think it's an amazing start. As I said, I don't expect that we will get nine for nine. It would be awesome if we did. But I'm really looking forward to the rest of the drill results, particularly on the basis of the core that we have currently in the trays and the results are pending on.
And how about those, you mentioned that sort of infrastructure that's being set up there now. Is that all completed now, or is there still some work going on there?
Yeah, well, we have roads to site here. So, we're able to drive in. We are building ourselves a new camp. So it's a purpose-built facility. At the moment, we're renting accommodation in the village. And we are building our own camp there, which will have the capacity to store well over 100,000 meters of core. And we have about 50,000 meters already drilled previously. I think it's important to point out, Steve, that this project already has a million ounce resource drilled off. And so we think that these new discoveries will add significantly to that. I think it'll be a while before we're able to come back with a revised resource estimate, since both the two initial discoveries will require some infill drilling. The other very interesting thing, which has been very surprising from the the results on the second of the two targets where we have results is that the tungsten values are very high. And we haven't seen that elsewhere on the project. The tungsten numbers are running around about 0.1 to 0.2%, but doesn't sound very high. But when you consider that tungsten is currently worth about $30,000 a ton, which is approximately five times the price of copper, it should add significantly to the overall in-ground value of the zone that we've discovered at Machichie East. So far, we've only sent a few samples off for analysis. But as I said, they are highly anomalous, and we'll be sending the rest of that particular hole for complete analysis.
Well, it's going to be fascinating to see what those results come back, and I look forward to hearing more about the next targets as well. Great to talk to you again, Alan, and enjoy your trip to Toronto. We'll see you when we get back to Vancouver.
Thanks very much, Steve.
All right, Alan Carter, the president and CEO of Cabral Gold.